Hey, this is Yulcia. I run a small investment firm that specializes in REIT investing. In today's video, I'm going to give you my latest thoughts on Realty Income's fourth quarter results, as well as its guidance for 2024. This video is probably going to be quite a bit shorter than usual because I'm currently on a cruise ship and my internet connection is simply too slow to upload any long videos, but I'll probably film a more detailed follow-up in the coming week. So if you don't want to miss it, make sure to subscribe to this channel. So there were some good and some bad about Realty Income's latest results. I'll start here with the good. And the main thing here is that they're guiding for a pretty solid growth rate in 2024. They expect their AFFO per share, which is their cash flow on a per share basis, to grow by 4.3% at the midpoint in 2024. And so that's a pretty solid growth rate for a net lease REIT like Realty Income, because if you pair that with their near 6% dividend yield, you're getting to roughly 10% annual total returns, which again, for mega cap investment grade REIT that has a very defensive business model, that's a pretty attractive risk to reward in my opinion. And then what makes this guidance even more compelling is the fact that they think that they can achieve it without having to tap the capital markets. So they don't think that they will need to issue new shares or raise new debt. And so this greatly increases the likelihood that they will reach their guidance or even perhaps surpass it in 2024, since they are not dependent on the capital markets. The issue here is that there is more to the story. And so now I'm coming to the bad part of Realty Income's results. A lot of investors see this 4.3% growth rate and they think this is great and they stop here, but you need to dig a bit deeper here to understand what's really happening. So just recently, Realty Income closed its acquisition of Spirit Realty Capital, which is another net lease REIT, and this is greatly going to contribute to its growth rate in 2024. This deal was accretive to Realty Income's AFFO per share because it was an all-stock transaction and Realty Income's valuation multiple was higher than that of Spirit Realty Capital. And so closing this deal has one-time benefits that will increase Realty Income's growth rate in 2024. So how much of that 4.3% is really the one-time benefits of closing the deal with Spirit Realty Capital? And according to our calculations, about 3% of the 4.3%, so about 3/4 of that growth is actually one-time and it's coming from closing this one deal. And so this means that the real growth that they expect to come from their regular business operations is just about 1.5%. Their growth is so slow because they're guiding to grow their same property rents by just 1%. Their interest expense is also going up, and they expect to do a lot less acquisitions in 2024 than they did in 2023. So they're guiding for about $2 billion of acquisitions this year, and that's down from nearly $10 billion in 2023. The reason why they're slowing down the acquisitions is because they're struggling to out-earn their cost of capital in today's market. So if you look at Realty Income's current share price, it's valued at about an 8% AFFO yield. Just recently, they accessed some debt at a 5.5% interest rate. If you use a 30% LTV, its weighted average cost of capital ends up being about 7.25%, slightly over 7%. But their cap rates that they got on new acquisitions last year was right around 7%. So there is no spread, or at best, if there is one, it's very small. And so for this reason, Realty Income is now slowing down its acquisitions and doing a lot less in 2024. So what this shows you is that if you remove the one-time impact of the Spirit Realty Capital acquisition, then the growth rate of Realty Income is actually very disappointing, and it's actually one of the lowest in its entire peer group. And unfortunately for Realty Income, it has acquired so many of its peers over the past decade that it's now running out of potential acquisition targets. We recently posted this table at High Yield Landlord, which is my REIT newsletter. If you want to access my entire portfolio, you can join it. By the way, there's a 2-week free trial. So we posted this table that showed the valuation of Realty Income relative to that of its close peers. And the main takeaway here is that Realty Income is today priced at one of the lowest valuation multiples in its peer group. And therefore, it wouldn't be possible for Realty Income to acquire its peers anymore, because that would be dilutive on a per share basis. And there were just two companies that were a bit cheaper. One was EPR Properties, but acquiring that REIT is very unlikely since it owns a lot of movie theaters and Realty Income has been trying to exit this segment of the net lease market. The other one was BNL, Broadstone Real Estate. Also, I think an acquisition here is very unlikely because they own a lot of industrial and medical properties, which is out of Realty Income's circle of competence. They've mostly retail sell on retail net lease assets in the past, but even if they acquired this REIT, the impact on its bottom line really wouldn't be significant because it's a fairly small REIT and there's not a big spread between the valuations of Realty Income and BNL. So what I'm trying to say here is that I don't think that they are going to be able to surprise us with another big acquisition this year, which would then boost the growth rate of 2025 or 2026. Rather, I think that it's likely that we see its AFFO per share growth rate slow down to 1 to 2% next year, which, and once that becomes clear to the market, it is possible that we'll be quite disappointed. Today, most peers of Realty Income are able to grow quite a bit faster. One REIT that I recently highlighted on this channel is called Essential Properties Realty Trust. It managed to grow its AFFO per share by 8% in 2023, and it's guiding for another 5% in 2024. 5% is actually below average for this REIT, and it thinks that it can achieve this without having to raise much equity at all. And so the reason why it's able to grow so much faster than Realty Income is because, for one, it has higher rent escalations in its leases. For two, it has less leverage, so it's not as heavily impacted by the surge in interest rates. And then the third reason is that today it's still able to earn good spreads over its cost of capital because it's focusing on a niche of the net lease market that has higher cap rates. Historically, REITs like Essential Properties Realty Trust have earned materially higher returns than a Realty Income, and I don't see this ending anytime soon. On the contrary, I think that the spread in their performance may even grow going forward because, as I mentioned earlier, Realty Income is running out of acquisition targets, and so it's not going to be able to make up for its slower growth rate by acquiring other REITs. As I mentioned earlier, I'm planning to film a more detailed follow-up in the coming weeks, so make sure to subscribe to this channel. If you thought that this information was valuable, please click the like button. That really helped me a lot to grow this channel. And then finally, once more, if you want to access my entire real money REIT portfolio, you can join my REIT newsletter, High Yield Landlord, for a 2-week free trial. I'll put a link to it in the description of this video. This is a real free trial, so you won't be charged anything in the first 14 days. If you want to come just to take a quick look at my portfolio and cancel, that's perfectly fine with me. Again, thank you very much for your interest, and see you at my next one. Bye-bye.